We're here on the 442 yard opening hole. This hole moves gently from left to right by virtue of the two sentinel trees that guard the right side of the hole. The play is toward the right edge of the bunkers that are on the left side of the hole. The fairway itself has a left to right slope, so shots hit at that right edge of the bunker will curl back into the middle of the fairway. Let's give it a shot and see how it turns out. That's pretty much how it was drawn up. Let's chase it and see how it turned out. We're 143 yards out, having successfully worked the ball off the slope of the left bunker. This green has a large bunker complex short and to the right, so the miss should always be a little bit left of the hole, potentially using the contour in the green to work your ball toward the hole. Let's hit a nice smooth 9-iron and see how it turns out. A little left of the hole, but it has turned out perfectly. Now I can use the contour to feed the ball toward the hole. Let's go have a putt. Here we are about 25 feet away on the left side of the hole. The flag's located on the central shelf, which is really the hardest pin placement to get close to. The key element here is to avoid hitting it beyond the hole and potentially having it run away down the hill. So my focus is going to be on speed. A touch left, but a tap in par. To recap, the play on this hole was up the left side, feeding the ball off the left bunker and into the middle of the fairway. Similarly, on the second shot, with the green being canted a little bit left to right, the play was up the left side with a conservative birdie putt to a pin placement in the middle of the green. On the approach, we made sure to avoid the big bunker in the front and the bunkers to the right, making for a pretty straightforward opening par.